Welcome to GYAS. How are you?
I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for that purpose, we have started MCQ series of different topics like Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, Geography, Polity, etc. So what we basically do in these series, we daily cover your 5 questions of each topic. And in this way, we will continue to do so till 31st May. So for example, we have 6 series. And of each series, we cover 5 questions daily. So we cover daily basis 30 questions. So of each series, we cover 5 questions and we will continue till 31st May. So in this manner, you can go by approximate calculation and approximately we will be covering 1000 questions of each topic till 31st May. So for example, we are on the lecture number 4 of geography. So we will today cover 5 questions of it. So already we are on the lecture number 19 of ancient India, lecture number 47 of environment, and already on others on other series we are already ahead of geography and polity because they are recently started, but the other series were started quite earlier. So let's just start our discussion. So friends, it is very important for you people to follow these series regularly. If you follow them regularly, you will certainly get an edge over others other students in your preliminary examination, because it will lead to your enough practice, and this is what needed in the UPSC prelims. Because the needed thing is that your concepts are clear and you must remember the facts. So that is the most important thing in your prelims. So if you as much as you practice, you must practice as much as possible. So let's start our discussion. The first question is, which of the following condition favor the formation of deltas? First statement is the coast should be sheltered, preferably tideless. Second is there should be a large lakes in the course of river that is to form the delta. Third is the sea adjoining the delta should be deep at shore. Fourth is there should be no strong currents running at right angles to the river mouth. So we have to choose the correct answer. So friends, let me tell you that the first statement is correct, that the coast should be sheltered, preferably tideless, because if the tides are there, then obviously the delta will not form, because the sediments will be washed away. So first is certainly the condition needed for the formation of delta. Regarding second, friends, second statement is incorrect, because if there are large lakes in the course of the river, then the sediments that the river carries in with it, they get deposited in these lakes. So when it enters the sea, it doesn't have much sediment. So sediment is the only reason due to which the delta forms. So if there is less sediment, then there will not be delta formation. So second is incorrect. The third is also incorrect, because friends, if the sea adjoining the delta is deep, then the sediments will go deep into the water and they will be lost. If the seashore is shallow, then certainly the sediments will be deposited there and it will lead to the formation of delta. So third statement is also incorrect. Regarding the fourth statement, there should be no strong currents running at right angles to the river mouth. Friends, yes, this statement is correct, because if there are strong currents running at right angles to the river mouth, then they will wash away the sediments. So in this way, the delta formation will not take place. So we have to choose the correct answer. So the correct answer is A, that is 1 and 4 only. So already I have provided to you in detail the explanation. So solution is A. So conditions that are favorable for delta formation are that there must be active erosion of the river in its upper course. So active erosion at the upper coast must take place so that to provide for extensive gravel, sand, silt to be eventually deposited as deltas. And in similar manner, if you see, the coast should be sheltered, preferably tideless. In similar manner, there should be no current running at right angle, and any larger lake in the way of river will filter off sediments. So the sea should also be shallow adjoining the delta, as sediments will disappear in the deep water. So this is about the explanation part of your question. So let's move on to the second question. The second question is, why limestone dominated areas have little agricultural activities and are sparsely populated? So here we have been asked that why the limestone dominated areas are sparsely populated and they have little agricultural activity. So the options are, limestone increases the acidity of the soil. B is limestone is soluble in water. C is limestone releases carbon dioxide that makes growing crops growing crops impossible in the area. D is all of the above. So let me tell you friends that the A is not the correct option, because in fact the limestone doesn't increases the acidity, it neutralizes the soil. If there is acidity in excess amount, then it neutralizes it. So the A option is certainly not the answer, but the B is answer, because limestone is soluble in water, so that's why it is not suitable to perform the agricultural activities, and that's why these areas are sparsely populated, because the land beneath these areas it gets eroded due to the limestone solubility in water. So the B is the correct answer. So friends, we provide the explanation of only first question, so that you might have an idea about the thing, that whether we are following the pattern of UPSC or not. From now onwards, we will not provide you the explanation. So if you want to get the explanation of all the questions, then you have to subscribe to our initiative that we are running, and how to subscribe it I will explain to you later. But we have just included the explanation in first question just for sample purposes. So let's move on to the third question. The third question is, the straits nearest to the international date line is. So friends, it is the easiest question. A option is Strait of Malacca, B is Bering Strait, C Strait of Hormuz, D Strait of Papua New Guinea. So the correct answer is Bering Strait. Friends, you know that the international line, the nearest strait to the international date line is Bering Strait, and Bering Strait it joins Arctic Sea with the Pacific Ocean, and also it separates Russia and Russian landmass and American landmass. So the solution is B. So let's move on to the fourth question. Consider the following statements. A statement is, assertion is, good fishing grounds can be found where marine upwelling is common. So reason is, water that rises to the surface as a result of upwelling is rich in nutrients. So friends, we have to choose the answer by seeing these assertion and reasoning. So good fishing grounds can be found where marine upwelling is common. Yes, this is true. We find the good fishing grounds where marine upwelling is common. So why the good fishing grounds are found there? Because the marine upwelling is kind of a water coming from the depth of the ocean towards the surface. So it is a little bit colder as compared to the surface water, and it brings it with it the nutrients. So in this way, the surface water gets nutrients. So if there are nutrients, then certainly the biological productivity will be higher there. So thus fishing grounds will be higher in such areas. So A is correct and R is correct. A is correct and reason is correct. Explanation of assertion. So the solution is A. That is, A is correct and R is an appropriate explanation of A. So let's move on to the last question. The last question is, mid-oceanic ridges form an interconnected chain of mountain system within the ocean. It is characterized by a central rift system at the crest. The rift system is at the crest is A, zone of maximum tectonic stability, B is zone of intense volcanic activity, C is plateaus of offshoot that has been stable over past some time, D is zone of Wagner's oscillations. So friends, let me tell you, it is also an easiest question. Mid-oceanic ridges, if you have heard about them in your geography part, they are formed as a part of seafloor spreading theory. So seafloor spreading theory was given by Harry Hess, and in which it was told that that oceanic crust spreads, and it spreads due to the kind of moving away of the plates from each other by the constant upwelling of the lava that comes out of the beneath the ocean surface to the surface of ocean, and gets cooled down and forms a long mid-oceanic chain of mountains. So it is basically a zone of intense volcanic activity. So the B option is correct option. So the solution is B. So friends, this is all about the lecture. So if you want to subscribe to the explanation PDF, then there is certain formality that you have to follow. But before explaining that, let me tell you why these explanation PDFs are important. Because friends, at the end of the day, you will not have the time to revise the entire syllabus by seeing 20 to 30 minute long videos. Also, you can't read bulky books at that time, because you will have multiple topics to revise, like you will have multiple things to focus upon, like economic survey, India yearbook, budget, and all other things. So at that time, if you started following standard books, then you will certainly face pressure and you will get confused. And also, friends, at that time, the time must be utilized in a maximum possible way, and it must not be lost in any negative thinking. So at that time, it is important for you people that you must have some kind of notes through which you can revise quickly, and those notes must be comprehensive so that your important concepts are covered appropriately, and you do not miss anything while going into the exam. So this is what the most of the students complain, that they do not satisfy with their notes. So friends, these questions and their answers are designed in such a manner that you get all the important facts and concepts in these questions, and they will help you in revision also, because friends, at the end, ultimately at the most, you can read a standard book 2 or 3 times. After that, it becomes boring. But the revision is the important role, has an important role to play in UPSC selection. So revision you must do, and for the purpose of making it interesting, the most accepted approach is question answer approach. So you go for a question, you go for its solution, and then you go for its explanation, and then you check that why a particular option is correct and why others are not correct. So friends, UPSC is different from other exams. It is not just about seeing a question and seeing its solution. It also needs you people to read the explanation also, because it clarifies your three more concepts along with the one concept, that is the right concept, that is the right answer. So it also tells you why the one option is correct and why the others are not correct, and in which context they will be correct. So in this way, if we are daily covering 5 questions, then by 31st May approximately 1000 questions will be covered. So you people will be getting approximately 1000 questions, but in fact of in number of concepts, then if you can multiply 1000 with 4, then you people will be getting 4000 concepts. And this is a very comprehensive coverage of your topic. So what are the formalities for joining this initiative? Let me tell you that, friends, we have multiple series like environment, ancient India, medieval India, modern India, geography, polity. So for which the cost is different for the explanation PDFs of which. So for environment, for example, it is rupees 50. So take the example of environment, friends. Let me tell you, it is not the cost of one single explanation PDF. It is the cost of all the explanation PDFs that you will get, that we have covered and that we are yet to cover. So for example, environment, we are on the lecture number 47. So all the PDF you subscribe to environment, you will get all the PDFs of environment that have been covered, and also you will be getting all the PDFs that we will cover till 31st May. So in a way, we have kept it very much affordable for you people, and also we have kept this minimum fee for the purpose of our motivation, because if we have accepted money from you people, then there is certain obligation that becomes on our part to for you people. If it is free, of course, then we will not have any obligation to you. So in this case, the accountability doesn't comes in. So the lectures are missed. So but in case if you have paid us, you will certainly question us that why we are not uploading the questions. So it brings also the much needed accountability, and also it brings in much needed seriousness, because the thing that is for free is not valued that much. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you liked it, and let me tell you that if you want to subscribe to this initiative, you can WhatsApp us at this number. This is our number, 8968426481. So lastly, friends, let me tell you that the entire cost for these series is 950. So if you want to get the complete package, then we are offering you complete package in just rupees 800. That is at a discount of rupees 150. So if you in case a student wants a complete package, he can get the complete package in just rupees 800 with a discount of rupees 150. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you liked it, please like it, please share it with your friends, and if you have any suggestion, please tell me in the comment box. I will certainly consider your suggestion. And lastly, friends, please subscribe to our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications of the updates that we do on YouTube. So thank you, friends, thank you very much.